Dear students, I am Nirmal Rai, Pakrat Government College. Today, I will discuss about transformation of sentences. In previous class, I discussed about sentence, simple, complex, and compound. I also discussed about clauses. Today, I would like to start about clauses. Clauses are divided into three sections. These are principal clause, subordinate clause, and coordinate clause. You know that principal clause doesn't depend on other clause. Principal clause expresses the sense of the speaker independently. So, its another name is independent clause. Independent clause. Clause. It is also called main clause. Main clause. Main clause. Now, about subordinate clause. Subordinate clause depends on principal clause while expressing the sense of the speaker. Subordinate clause. And coordinate clause, while principal clauses are connected with coordinating conjunctions, these are called coordinate clauses. Subordinate clause. Subordinate clause are divided into three sections. Subordinate, subordinate clause, subordinate clause. Subordinate clauses are divided into three sections. These are noun clause. Number one, noun clause. Number two, adjective clause. Adjective clause. And number three, adverbial clause. Adverbial clause. Subordinate clauses depends on principal clauses while expressing the sense of the speaker. These subordinate clauses are divided into three sections. These are noun clause, adjective clause, and adverbial clauses. Now we have to know about the pattern of noun clause, the type of adjective clause, and adverbial clauses. Noun clause. We can identify noun clause by its function. Function. Functions of noun clause. Noun clause. Function of noun clauses. Number one, subject. Subject. non plus x as subject, object, object of preposition, complement, five functions. There are five functions of noun clauses. You know the function of noun. You know that noun acts as subject, object, object of preposition, complement and accusative. Such is the function of noun phrase, and such is the case of noun clauses. Noun clause acts as subject. While she went there is a mystery. Why she went there? This is a clause. As it has subject C and funny dot point, so it's a clause. Here, this noun clause acts as a subject. If a clause acts as a subject, there will be no doubt that it's a noun clause. Now, function of noun clause as object. Noun clause acts as object also. He said that he was ill. He was ill. This is a clause. And this acts as a object. Object of verb said that he was ill is an object of verb said. If a clause acts as an object, it's noun clause. It's no other than noun clause. Subject, object. Now, object of preposition, preposition, our future depends on how we work. On how we work. Here, on is a preposition, and how we work acts as the object of preposition on. If a clause acts as the object of preposition, it's surely a noun clause. Subject, object, object of preposition, complement, complement, complement. It is what I expected. It is what I expected. What I expected. It's a noun clause. It's the object of its complement. It's a complement of subject it. Now, appositive. Appositive or case in apposition. 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 Noun clause also acts as appositive or case in apposition. The remark. Remark that he is a saint. is false. The remark that he is a saint, is appositive of the noun remark. It is non-clause. If a clause functions as subject or object or object of preposition, complement and appositive, this clause is of course non-clause. This clause is no other than non-clause, because noun acts as subject, object, object of preposition, complement and appositive. This is the function of noun phrases and noun clauses. Today I discussed about noun clauses. In next class I will discuss about other clauses. Thank you all, dear students. In next class we will discuss about other clauses. Thank you all.